Imagine your life without building services engineering. You would not be able to shower or wash, cook or do any of the things you normally do. There would be no lights in our streets or buildings, and the world would look and feel a very different place. Building services engineering plays an important part in our lives. It provides a comfortable environment that you would want to live or work in.
I'm Gemma Martland. I'm in my third year of my apprenticeship heating and ventilation, working for Shepherd's Engineering Services. When I left school, I didn't really know what I wanted to do, so I thought if I learnt a trade and a skill, I'd always have it to fall back on. And through my apprenticeship, I go to college for 2 to 3 weeks, and then I'm out on site getting site evidence, which puts together a portfolio to work towards a certificate. I enjoy learning different things every day and picking up new skills and more knowledge each time I go back to college and then bringing them out to site and using them. Each site I go on to is a different challenge. Obviously being a woman, it's uncomfortable for those around me, but as soon as they see me working, they realise I can do the job and that's what I'm there to do. Tong High School's a new build and it's mainly an underfloor heating system which I've installed the pipework to and to the domestics, which would be toilets and sinks. As I've progressed towards my level 2 certificate, I've gone on to level 3, which I'm actually training to weld at the moment, which is a good skill to have. And my company have successfully led me on to design, which by the end of it I could go into engineering. I'd encourage people to join the industry. It's something new every day and you're always learning.
I started as a graduate engineer at Brewer-Heppel. And I follow a structured CIBSE SIPSE training scheme within the company. I've been involved with a wide range of projects from schools to offices and residential buildings. Over the last 6 years, I started developing my career into also a managing role in leading a small team of engineers and technicians to deliver building design. I can help improve the environment. That's what keeps me here every day, to deliver the best energy efficient design we possibly can achieve. I would strongly recommend people to join the building service industry and also work as a building services engineer. I think we are at the forefront to deliver an environmentally responsible building and also tackle climate change.
I started my apprenticeship with H&A Mechanical Services. I did my MVQ Level 2 and my MVQ Level 3 in Ballymena Training Centre. Last year I went on ahead to do my BPEC, which leaves me qualified to install solar panels. I don't have a typical day. One day I could be doing gas heating, any other day it could be installing solar panels, commissioning solar panels or commissioning gas boilers or commissioning oil boilers. For someone thinking of choosing this career, I think it's a very good idea. There's so many different paths you can go down for the plumbing industry, but it's not only the plumbing industry, it's now renewable energy, which is a lot more skilled and technical. Renewables is good because the government's trying to reduce everybody's carbon emissions and it contributes to homeowners because of their heating costs being reduced during the year. It's a very fast growing industry, and there's always going to be more work for anybody joining the industry.
Well, I left school at 17 and started an apprenticeship then, passed my sec test and got an opportunity of a job that way. There had been a job advertised. I did my 3 years training in Bembecula on the MOD base and worked for a couple of years after I'd finished my training before moving to Inverness. Well, I actually went to a careers interview and I didn't really have any ideas as to what I wanted to do because I had a young baby at the time and that's why we moved to Inverness, and I went for a careers interview and they gave me my perfect job, which was passing on my skills to others. So I got back in touch with my lecturers at the college because this is where I trained, and that's how I got back into it.
When I left school, I went to Beresford College in Nottingham to start doing refrigeration air conditioning MVQ2. And then when I completed that, I did the MVQ3 in air conditioning and refrigeration. I'm at college one day a week, and then I'm at work for 4 days of the week. At college, we've concentrated on the theory, and then obviously when we're at work, we do all the practical, and that's where we get to see all the sites and put what we learned at college into practice. The refrigeration is extremely important. You use it every day, even if you don't realise it. Even the air conditioning, the milk you drink, and even the cars that you drive today, they're all tested in refrigeration conditions. The new technology we're working with is a CO2 ammonia refrigeration system. Both the refrigerants are natural, so they don't damage the ozone layer, and they're very environmentally friendly. One of the biggest challenges I've had to face is my confidence. I've had to build up my confidence to be able to go on site by myself and speak to the customers. Star Refrigeration have been very helpful, they've been very encouraging, and they've helped me to get confidence by sending me with engineers and helping and getting me to do the main role in the job. As an industrial refrigeration engineer, in the future I'm able to progress and do either industrial, commercial or air conditioning refrigeration. This is very varied. I could work at either a milk factory or at somewhere like Cosworth Cars with the test engines. I enjoy this industry because it's moving all the time. There's always something you don't know, so every day you do learn something.
Back when I left school, 16 years of age, I embarked on electrical apprenticeship. Did that for 4.5 years. Then became a qualified electrician on site. I chose not to continue the path on site, and I decided that I wanted to give the office side a go. Juggling a day-to-day job and doing a part-time degree is a hard situation, but again, if you're willing to put the effort in, you can always do it. So then, because I could actually do my own job as a quantity surveyor, I got a promotion then, so I became the quantity surveyor that I wanted to be. And now I've been doing that for approximately 3 years, and I'm just at that stage now where, as I've been as like a system QS and a QS now for the past 5-6 years, I'm looking now to be promotion for senior quantity surveyor.
This is the site that I'm working on at the moment in Coventry. It's a £500 college block.
You never know what you're going to do in a day. It's always changing, it's always diverse. Never 2 days exactly the same. It's a good varied job, and I'm sure if numerous people who are watching this now come into the industry, a few years down the line, you'll be saying, you know what, I've heard a few people say this industry is good to work in, and I'm one of those people now, I really enjoy it.
At the moment, I'm a project engineer. I really enjoy my job role, and I look forward to coming to work every day. In this role, in this job, there isn't really a typical day as such. There is a typical job, but that could cover anything from 6 weeks to a year. One of the big issues which is coming out more and more in construction projects is the environment. Everything we do is geared towards saving energy, making the building more efficient. Westminster Academy as a building is a state-of-the-art system. All of the design is very high spec. The ventilation, the cooling, air conditioning is all very high level, and it's got things that modern offices don't have. Being able to see a construction project right from design, drawings, planning, installation, it's fantastic. It's like knowing every little bit. The chances are I will know more about that school and building than anybody that ever occupies it, and I'll know about how it works, and for me that's just really interesting. Every time I'm offered the opportunity to learn something new, I will dive at it. I'm soon to be starting an HND at South Bank University, and from there, hopefully I'll move on to make it a degree.
In your home, the systems you take for granted, such as the plumbing, heating, electrical power, air conditioning, ventilation and refrigeration, all contribute to your everyday way of life. Even in sports stadiums, airports and office blocks, building services engineering provides the vital services for everyday living. With the growing complexity of modern buildings and the significance of energy conservation and emissions control, the role of building services engineers, electricians, plumbers, heating, ventilating, refrigeration and air conditioning engineers is becoming increasingly important. In addition, the need to provide an internal environment that balances the comfort needs of the occupants with the functional requirements of the building calls for engineers with a wide range of knowledge and skills. Imagine a world without any light, heating, ventilating, air conditioning, refrigeration, water or electricity. It is the job of people working in the building services engineering sector to design, install and maintain all these facilities so that you can work, rest and play in a comfortable and safe environment.